Salut comrades and welcome back to Let's Play Hearts of Iron 3. My name is Vadim and like what's the worst thing that can happen to you? Yeah, but really what is the worst thing that can ever possibly happen to you? Like think about it. Like I don't know. Maybe leave a comment. Yeah. I will give you some time to do that. About like no, let's give you some like 10 seconds. Okay. 10 seconds. Write a comment. What's the worst thing that can happen to you? Okay, I guess you've left the comment. And how about this? How about like it's a casual morning, sun is shining, and all of a sudden you have a note that USSR goes to war, declares war on you. Yeah, how about that? Think about it, like. Germany have its this moment in this video, in the very beginning, and so it fucked. It really, really fucked, and sucks for them, because you see, now they have two fronts to fight: our front and the Eastern Front, and I don't know how they will deal with this news. But it sucks for them. I don't wish to be Germany right now. So, and the worst thing for them, even worse, what it makes even worse for them, is my upgrades are complete. Like my troops are fighting better and better with each second. I conquered my territories back. Yeah, I have a shitload of industrial capacity. My troops are almost completely reinforced, and as I will reinforce them to the last soldier, I will have enough manpower to build new armies. So sucks to be Germans right now. They didn't even take Paris. No, they haven't reached like no single soldier of Germany reached Paris. Yeah, so they actually could. There were some times when they almost completely encircled it, but they never made a final push to it. So, like, sucks for them. And, by the way, if they would take Paris, I guess it would make the surrender of Germany much, of France much faster. And, as I said in my previous video, the French surrender would be almost a game over for me. Almost. I don't know how I would do if France surrender. But now my situation is doing great. Like Germans, they need to redeploy lots of their troops to the Eastern Front because of the war, new war. And one more thing, because the Eastern Front, on Eastern Front, there will be some fights. The fights means that Germany will take losses in this fight, and this will benefit me because to reinforce troops you need manpower, and Germany I guess have like almost zero manpower, and like it can reinforce only small amount of divisions every day. So if on the Eastern Front there will be losses. That's mean the Germans will reinforce like only half of divisions on the Western Front that it used to reinforce. So that's mean every day will be like shittier and shittier for Germany. And because of my troops are fighting better, I start to taking lots of provinces back. One of it sucks that one of army of my of combined USA and French army is that was encircled. It finally destroyed. Yeah, that sucks. They had there were 12 divisions, like 12 good divisions, but without supplies they had no chance, just even though they was on heavily reinforced territory, they was encircled and destroyed, so they didn't survive just a couple of weeks to the like breaking the encirclement. So yeah guys, let's have a minute of silence for this one man, brave man. Okay, that was a minute of silence, the quick one, but anyway. So, USSR actually starts to losing its territories, plus they have a war with Japan. Historically, on this period of war, USSR didn't fight Japan, but in this turn of events, when USSR declared war on Germany, it declared war on everybody, yeah, on every Axis party. So Japan starts to pushing the USSR back. Germany starts to winning. And actually, guys, I have a confession to make. Like when I did one of my previous video, I've checked out the nations and what are they? It's their situation. And USSR, it's a fluke. Okay, well, it was a fluke. When I checked, they had. They had insane amount of divisions and brigades. I guess they have more than 2,000 of brigades. Yeah, 2,050, I guess. 500. 2,500. And like United Kingdom, Germany, we have about 500 division. Yeah, so they have 5 times more than we have. But the problem is that USSR, almost all of USSR divisions are the reserved ones. That means they have only, I don't remember, or 10 or 25% of men in it. And so they are completely unfightable. Yeah. Not unfightable, I mean they cannot fight. Yeah. They are weak, very weak. And I've checked to make all of this reserve division the regular ones. USSR requires 3,000 of manpower. It's insane amount. Like I never saw this amount of manpower ever. And the USSR will never have this amount of manpower, so all of its division will stay reserved, yeah. And USSR don't have enough manpower to even reinforce the divisions that are in combat. So USSR, although it have this large of an army, it's a fluke. It cannot fight ever. So it can be easily conquered. But the problem is it can be conquered by us, but it can be conquered by Germany. And Germany already starts taking its territory and Japan too. So USSR, if they will reach Moscow, USSR will almost immediately surrender. And because in this game, for USSR, like you take Moscow, it surrenders usually. So we have to give, like, to push into German territory and not to let them to do this. And actually, we're doing pretty good right now, even though we have lots of troops around us. We're pushing forward, and that's good. So, guys, in the next video we will do this, but for now that's it. And comrades, dismissed.